episode 2684, Never Quit at the Bottom of the Pile.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy day. How are you feeling? Come on, you want to have a marvelous week. And so why not kick it off with a grand mindset? One that allows you to step into your leadership. One that says, you know what? I'm going to own the spot that I'm in today. I'm going to create my now because guess what? Never quit at the bottom of the pile. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kiss of newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Whether you're clawing for a ball or just happened to take another fall, never quit at the bottom of the pile. Create your now every day in business and in life. You know, how many times have you threatened to give up? Think about that. Don't jump to a quick answer. Or maybe you made a strong inference that you've had enough and you're moving on. I can't do this anymore. That's it. I'm done. I'm walking away. Yet, here you sit today wondering if you could still do what you thought about months or even years ago. Why are you playing with your cortisol that way anyway? Yeah, you are, because you're increasing your stress and your cortisol is like all over the place. Enough is enough. At some point, you need to commit beyond your excuses and circumstances to where you stand in your goals and dreams. However, that commitment cannot be one that you break easily with yourself. Let's be real. You and I have both broken our own commitments to ourselves. Guilty as charged, which really should be the most traumatizing break ever. But we shrug our shoulders and move on as if nothing really ever happened. Nothing to look at here. Just move on. Or do you? Tuning in to watch the Birmingham Stallions this weekend, they were playing football and it was in the second quarter. And I was caught a little off guard when I saw the score. How could the only undefeated team in the USFL be losing to the Pittsburgh Stars? Don't confuse yourself with the Dallas Stars. I know that's hockey. So you got to keep all this stuff straight. We know we've got the playoffs happening for hockey and Stanley Cup's coming up soon. But you know, we're talking football right now. Well, oddly enough, they were losing until the defense created an opportunity when the Stars quarterback was tackled. The ball came loose in the pile. It was a free-for-all. Finally, one player came up with the football. It was the Stallions. So excited they were until they couldn't capitalize with a touchdown and had to kick for field goal. Yes, they had a hope, which the soccer player hit the upright square on, causing it to deflect out of the goalpost. Not a good ending to the first half of the game with only 10 seconds left. Pretty much sums up our lives at times, doesn't it? But you know what? The Stallions came back to win the game, holding the Stars to a big fat zero in points scored. Yeah. The ending game, 30-17. You see, the Stars at halftime were 17. They didn't score any points. The Stallions came back and said, you know what? We got this. The bottom of the pile was the turning point. Never quit at the bottom of the pile. Keep fighting for more because you were created for more. But for some reason, you and I both need a little convincing sometimes. So get ready to dig out of the pile. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Get ready to dig out of the pile. It's time you become a force to be reckoned with. No more excuses. No more boundaries that confine your creativity. No more hesitation to begin again. No more questioning your gifts and talents. No more hiding behind what you don't know. No more playing small. No more. It's time you dig out of the pile. Number one, you got to lead with forgiveness. You got to start there. You can't question what you decided days, months, and years ago. You did the best that you can at that time. Now, that doesn't mean you don't learn along the way. It's just that the beating stops so you can start. So you got to lead with forgiveness. Let bygones be bygones. Yeah, don't blame it on the kids anymore. Don't even use them as an excuse. Don't sit there and say your spouse made you do it. You got to drop all of that. Lead with forgiveness so what? You can get out of the mess that you're in. You got to get out from underneath the pile, right? That's what we're doing. You got to dig out of the pile. Number two, get your hands dirty. Oh, yeah. I was planting this weekend and I was dealing with this grass. Now, I call this grass monkey grass. I really don't know if it's monkey grass. I heard about monkey grass, I don't know how many decades ago. And to me, monkey grass is like this little clump of grass that you, it's kind of like an ornamental grass and you just plant it and then it grows right where it is. Well, this grass that I have is nothing like it, but it's kind of like a monkey, right? It just kind of goes wherever it wants to go. It doesn't stay on the one branch you want it to stay on. Well, this grass grows everywhere and it grows thick, you know, like sod. Yeah, I'm sitting here cutting out 4 to 5 inches worth of this monkey grass. Now, don't send me your emails and pictures saying, well, this, Christiana, is actually what monkey grass looks like. But let me tell you that I can tell you, you got to get your hands dirty if you want to get out underneath the pile. You got to get in there. You got to dig deep, no matter what you're going after. It could be the monkey grass. It can be a health goal, career goal, retirement goal. Maybe it's your dream home, your family dream. It's like, this is what we want to do. You want to go buy a farm with 20 acres and have horses and cows and pigs and chickens. And you want to write a book there. And you want to minister to people. Is that you? Then you got to get your hands dirty. Maybe it's your knock it out of the park goal. You're going to have to buckle down and do what it takes. Dig in the dirt and get a little dirty. That monkey grass is not going to go away on its own. I even asked my mom, do you think I could burn it? She goes, no, you live in the historic district. You'll probably burn down an oak tree or something. Of course, I'm not going to burn it down, but it was making me that mad and that crazy. I'm like, seriously, but our lives are like that too. It's like this monkey grass. It's so thick. We can't get out from underneath the pile. If you're playing football and you're going for that ball because that's the one thing you need in order to score. Right? You want to win the game. You want to win the game of life. You got to be able to get out from underneath the muck and the yuck, and you got to get on top. Lead with forgiveness. Get your hands dirty. That's how you're going to learn, right? How you're going to grow. How you fail fast forward, which leads you to miles of greatness in the long run. And finally, number three, take aim. Action ignites motivation. There is no time like the present. When was the best time to plant that oak tree? The one that, yeah, if I would have burned down the monkey grass, maybe that oak tree wouldn't still be standing there, but it's fine, it's fine. Don't send those emails either. But the best time to plant that oak tree was 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 40 years ago. But since it's not planted, today is the best day to plant it. The presence counts. Did you know what happened last night? Lunar eclipse, blood moon on top of that. It's only one of two lunar eclipses this year. I think the next one comes like November 8th. And all of this was happening. And when I was reading about it, the best time when everything was to come together for Central Standard Time, that's where we're located, was 11:11. And if you know anything about numbers, woo, that's all I got to say. Take aim. The presence counts. So do something every day towards what matters. You matter. Your goals and dreams matter. And as a bonus, honor your timeline as best as possible. Life does happen and you can adjust, but don't let that become an overarching theme to your everyday. It's real easy for us to say, you know what? Life happens. Yeah, it does. And there's certain things. There's family emergencies. There's, you know, health crises. There's stuff with the house or weather-related issues that come up. And you truly have no control over it, right? You have a life and death circumstance that occurs, whether it's directly related to you or within your family and friend circles. But we can't let that overarching theme be the theme of our everyday. We've got to figure out, okay, where is there really a fire that needs to be put out? And where is it that, well, they think it's a fire and really it's not even a spark? It's just a pilot light. And if I don't go add fuel to the fire, it's going to be all right. So lead with forgiveness. Get your hands dirty. Take aim and honor your timeline. You've got what it takes to live out your dreams and achieve your goals. So talk about it and then go after it. Never quit at the bottom of the pile. It's time to dig out and create your now. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.